これがレクイエム。
What's good, YouTube? It's your boy Show back with another video, and today we're talking about Pokemon Snap. Now, the thing for me is, a Pokemon Snap is just such a legendary thing. And honestly, I used to just put so much time in that game for no apparent reason, just to take pictures of Pokemon. Now, most people may look at Pokemon Snap on the outside and say, why do I want a game where I take pictures of Pokemon? And I say to them people, I understand. You know, honestly, I understand why a lot of people may not like Pokemon Snap or may not feel Pokemon Snap is, you know, even worthy of being a game. Honestly, I think in general, when I first played Pokemon Snap, like the original one, it came at a time of great boredom. Like, not only did I actually have nothing to play, but for me, it's just like, yeah, I was bored. I had nothing to do. I decided to pop in that Pokemon Snap. I don't actually know how I got it. I just had it for some reason. You ever had those games where you just basically don't know where it came from when you were younger? Like, you don't know if your mother or father or whatever bought it. You didn't know. You just kind of felt like it just was there. It just appeared for you. Like it was meant for you to be. I remember because it just always felt like this mystical game. You know, you would turn it on. You had like the little roller coaster thing. You would basically try to take pictures of the Pokemon. And, you know, different Pokemon would pop up. And they would be everywhere. It's like they were in their natural habitat. And it was like basically made the Pokemon feel a little bit more real. We always familiar with Pokemon back in the day, you know, whether we played on the Game Boy Color, Game Boy Advance, just in general. We all remember Pokemon from back in the day, and it was amazing to see all these different Pokemon, like, running around and having fun and just really enjoying life, it seems. I've always felt that, like, the game was mildly underrated because it's just, between that and, like, a couple of Mario games, I really had nothing else to play. So playing that and just going over there and taking beautiful pictures of Pokemon, and it was amazing. You know, like trying to get that legendary, trying to catch that legendary that's in the camera. Because you always felt like they were just mystical creatures. You know, it really puts you on a mindset. These creatures, these Pokemon are mystical. Like in order to capture them, you have to be quick. You know, you have to deserve it. You have to be worthy to catch them. Now, mind you, I was young. So, all this was running through my head. I was very young at the time. But now, having a new Pokemon Snap allows, you know, younger audience to feel the same way that I felt back then. When, you know, I put on the game, I first played the game. I honestly think that it's such a unique way of expressing love for Pokemon that it will, you know, bring a lot of newer, younger audiences into the Pokemon franchise. I gotta say though, I don't think that it should come out anywhere around $60. I know a lot of the times when you come out with a game, it's like not necessarily a remake. This isn't really a remake. When you come out with a game that's already been established and it's already great, people want to, you know, spend $60 on it. They want to be like, hey, this game costs $60. Like the Borderlands collection might come out or something like that. And they'll be like, hey, this is $60. You know, I'm just using that as an example. But in reality, that's what they do. A lot of these companies try to come out with a game that's not really fully fleshed out. And not saying that I know what's going to be going on with Pokemon Snap, because I really don't. Like I said, I've said in multiple videos before, I'm one of the people that don't like to look at much, you know, things revolving around games. Just normally, if I'm excited for a game, I don't look at it. Because just to get in there and see what I can see and do what I can do makes the game 10 times better. Now, with that being said, though, I'm wondering, like, how many Pokemon it may take place. I'm assuming, you know, just off my base assumptions, let's say I haven't watched anything or read anything, I'm assuming they might have a wide variety of Pokemon, because considering that we've had so many different Pokemon generations after the original Pokemon Snap, I can't even see it being limited to, you know, only the first couple of Pokemon, because I don't think it's a remake, so it's obviously just a new, entirely new game, so it should be interesting, like I said, to see, you know, really what it all holds, because it's such a fun game back on, you know, the original system that, like I said, I would spend hours just trying to take photos of different Pokemon for no apparent reason. I mean, there was no reason to go out there and take photos. There was no reason to do any of that. I could have went outside and played. And that was back before the time when people really was in the house all day and you just play video games with your friends online. Like, this game really changed the way I looked at games in general. Changed the way I looked at Pokemon. It made me really get into Pokemon on the handheld, on the Game Boy Advance. I really love how the Pokemon were just out there thriving in the world, and you were just taking nice pictures of him, and it was just a really amazing scene. So, with that being said, guys, what do you think you might see from Pokemon Snap? Obviously, you guys may be even well informed, even against me, because I haven't watched too much about Pokemon Snap, because I am very excited for it. I'm hoping that we get the Pokemon Diamond and Pearl announced. We definitely need to get that remake announced. That's something that's needed to be day one. But I'm curious to see what's all going to happen for the Pokemon anniversary and what they plan on dropping for that. Because I feel like that would be really interesting. Honestly, I could see Pokemon Snap being like a very cheap Pokemon game that, you know, just really can gather interest into future Pokemon fans. Let me know if you played the original Snap and how did it make you feel when you played it. Did you love it? Did you hate it? Let me know in the comments down below, and I'll see you guys next video.